We'll start with a brief overview of what's in the control room for doing studio productions, and then we'll get into the details of how to turn on everything and fire up the studio for an actual studio production. A brief overview is this section of the control room is primarily for producing audio during productions. We have the main mixing board for controlling the audio levels for sound. We have some tape recorders, CD players, and radios and tape players for adding extra things to the sound, as well as a turntable, keyboard, drum machine. And a lot of the extra material goes through the auxiliary soundboard. And that all blends sound for doing productions, live or post. Okay, this next area is predominantly for producing the video of the program and mixing it together. Here we have the video mixer, which combines the different cameras and different other video sources to create your imagery for a video production. And you have monitors for all your production, your viewing of things, and your preview monitors and your output monitors, and some measuring devices. Also on this console is the lighting control board for all the lighting in the studio. So we have the sound section over here for recording, for producing sound. We have the video section over here for producing the imagery. Those are combined, and over in this rack, which is our first rack, is where all the recording devices sit for using this section of the studio. We can record on mini DV tape, VHS tape, or super VHS tape, and we can record on DVDs. And we also have some other source equipment in here, such as satellite receivers and sync generators and black burst generator, color bar generator. And if we move to the right of this, this is where our graphics production takes place for putting titling in live and different animations and things. We'll get to that later. We also have a series of patch bays. Now what patch bays are is it allows the connections on specific machines to be all put in one place so that you can interconnect machines without having to go and rewire behind the machines and rewiring them that way. All the connections are put up front for video and audio, which makes it easier to move the signals around in the studio. Okay, on the back side of the studio, we have what I consider more the post-production kind of equipment. We have distribution equipment for broadcasting within the building and outside of the building over cable access stations. We have a computer for recording the signals coming in and out, and also for doing some offline stuff and editing, post-production work, and playback. And again, we have another patch bay in here, which interconnects all the machinery on this side of the room. It's also connected to the other patch bay or the other console, so all this equipment can be interconnected. We have recorders for DV, DVD, VHS, monitoring systems, some correcting equipment for correcting video images, broadcast equipment. This is primarily a broadcast area. If we go over here, we have what's called duplication equipment. We have more equipment for recording and duplicating, as well as recording things off the air. A couple computers for adding more graphics. Various sources on the bottom. We have a VHS, high 8 and 3/4 inch for dumping different materials into programs and transferring. And basically, this is all post-production area. This is stuff we use primarily after productions are done.